Welcome, welcome. The Angry Appliance Repair Person. For the record, you're looking at him. This presentation is going to be about dishwashers. A common question that I get from homeowners. They open the door, they're going to unload it, and there's a little bit of water in the bottom. And they're thinking, well, why is there a little bit of water down there? The dishwasher should have drained it out. So I better call for service. That is not necessarily true. A little bit of water down in what we call the sump of the dishwasher is normal. There is an area on the bottom of the dishwasher, normally there's a filter down there, not all the time, and that water sits in there to keep everything wet and lubricated. So the unit will turn on and it drains almost every dishwasher. As soon as you turn it on, will drain any old water that's left in there. They do that on purpose. So that water will be there and shoot through the pump, keeping everything lubricated or primed, as we say. So to see a little bit of water at the bottom is normal. Now, one of the big questions we get in this situation is how much is normal? That's a good question. How much water down there is normal? Most dishwashers have a screen on the bottom. Most of the time, you might see a little bit of water on the screen itself. Never enough that you can splash it. That's not good. But you should see it, might see a little bit of water on top of the screen. Almost always, that water will be under the screen. That you will not see it unless you take the filter out. 90% of the new dishwashers have cleanable filters. I have talked about it in previous presentations. But just as a reminder, you need to take that filter out and clean it. When you take the filter out, there will be some water left in that sump area. That's fine. When you put the filter back in, that water should be under the filter screen if it has one. Some manufacturers have a screen on the bottom. Some manufacturers have a round sump area that the water sits in there. And you can't see it, but again, it is not unusual to have a little bit of water around that sump area. If you think your dishwasher has a drain problem, don't panic. Don't call for service right away. If you think that that water on the bottom is too much, it is a very easy test. Shut the door. Every dishwasher has a cancel cycle. Everyone. You can figure out how your cancel cycle works on your dishwasher by looking in your manual or going to the manufacturer's website if you don't know. Put it in a cancel cycle. It's about 2 minutes long. Let it run, open the door, and see if that water is gone. If it is, that means your drain pump is working. If you want to test it, put it on a rinse. Rinse only takes about 10 minutes. Close the door, let it fill with water, wash and drain on its own till it stops, and open the door and see if that water is still there. Every once in a while, you can get something in the screen that slows the flow of the pump down and doesn't allow all the water to drain. So always try it before you call. But you should have some water sitting in the bottom of the dishwasher, but not a lot. Keep that in mind. It is not broken. It is meant to be there. As long as you keep that screen clean, and as long as your drain line is cleaned out enough that that water flows good, you should be fine. So keep that in mind when you see the water. Don't all of a sudden call for service, pay the money for a guy to come out there and say, oh no, ma'am, that's normal. You must have water down there. So a little bit of water is fine. A lot is a problem. But you can test it yourself by canceling the cycle, run it through a console, and see what happens. Keep that in mind before you panic that you think your dishwasher is broken. Now, for the senile thought each week, we are going to discuss finding a service person. Now, I have talked about this many, many times. Whether you want to ask a family member, whether you want to go on a recommendation from a dealer. But let's say you're out in the middle of nowhere and you bought your appliance online. You don't really have a dealer to talk to and you don't know what to do. You can call the company, as I have said in the past, and you can ask for an authorized service agent. An authorized agent that is actually authorized in, let's use our makeup brand, for example. Sage, this particular customer has an abracadabra dishwasher, and she needs her abracadabra dishwasher serviced. She can call abracadabra and ask them, is there someone that can service my appliance in nowhere, USA? Most all manufacturers have someone that they have authorized for that area. Now, for this senile thought, let's say there's more than one. Let's say there's three that they give you for your zip code, and you don't know which one to choose. A lot of times, saying that you're authorized is not saying that you know what you're doing. Back in the 80s, they actually wanted to make sure that when you were authorized in something, that you knew something. They would send out a representative, they would sit down with us, and they would ask us questions just to make sure we weren't total idiots and we knew what we were doing for that abracadabra appliance. Well, today is different. Today's world, they are so desperate for people, just a human, warm body, that you could basically sign up for authorization over the phone. You do not need to prove that you know anything or not to be authorized. And that's a little scary, because you never know if the person who is authorized knows what they're doing. So the only advice I have for you, if there is no one to ask, that's when you can check online. You can watch Angry Appliance Repair Pusson, and we will try to educate you a little bit into how appliances work and when little things pop up, so you can listen to this person just to make sure that he or she understands that they know what they are doing. But just because they are authorized in today's world doesn't necessarily mean they know what they're doing. I have had lots of experience with going out behind an authorized person who couldn't fix it, and we had to step in and take care of it. So keep that in mind. Just because they're authorized doesn't always mean they know what they're doing. But if you have no one else to use and you have no idea who to call, it's a good place to start, because if they're authorized and they mess things up, you can go back to, in this example, Abracadabra Appliance Company and say, hey, this guy was authorized and he did this, this, and this, and it's still not fixed, and charged me this amount. They will hopefully help you try to get your problem resolved, even though that authorized servicer couldn't do it. At least you have something to use as backup, just in case. And as always, we thank you for spending some of your day with us.